Welcome to this YouTube tutorial on pivot points in Blender. As a 3D modeling and animation software, Blender offers a plethora of powerful tools to create and manipulate objects. One such tool is pivot points, which enable you to control the point around which an object rotates or scales. Mastering the use of pivot points can significantly enhance your workflow and accelerate your modeling and animation process. It allows for more accurate and efficient manipulation of objects, resulting in a more polished final product. So, whether you're a seasoned Blender user or just starting, mastering the pivot point is a must. In this tutorial, we will talk about the fundamentals of pivot points in Blender and explore some practical use cases. So, let's dive in and learn how to use pivot points effectively. What is a pivot point? A pivot point is a crucial element that enables objects to rotate, scale, or transform around a specific point. It is the central point from which the object pivots or rotates, and it plays a fundamental role in effective 3D modeling and animation. The pivot point determines how an object behaves when manipulated, and it can be set to different locations based on the user's needs. Blender offers several pivot point options, including the median point, individual origins, 3D cursor, bounding box center, and active element. By selecting the appropriate pivot point option, users can manipulate their objects with greater precision and control. The 3D cursor is an incredibly powerful tool in Blender that serves as a pivot point for transforming objects. To select this mode, go to the Pivot Point drop-down menu and select it from the list. This feature is particularly useful when you need to pivot or rotate objects around a specific point in your scene, such as the corner of a cube. By selecting the 3D cursor as the pivot point, it becomes the center of rotation, scaling, or transformation for any selected objects. The Individual Origins pivot point is a tool in Blender that allows users to rotate, scale, and move selected objects independently from each other. The Individual Origins pivot point can be accessed through the pivot point menu in the viewport. While the other pivot point modes transform the whole selection around one point, Individual Origins transforms each item around itself. When using this pivot point, each selected object will rotate or scale in its own individual origin point rather than around a shared center point. Also, if we get into edit mode real quick and select some faces, it works the same. This feature can be particularly useful when working with complex objects that have multiple parts or when working with objects that need to be transformed in a specific way. The Active Element pivot point is another useful tool in Blender that allows users to transform selected objects based on a specific active element. This pivot point can be accessed through the pivot point menu in the viewport. When using the Active Element pivot point, the active element serves as the center point for transformations, such as scaling or rotating. To put it simply, the pivot point is placed at the active element, which is the element that was most recently selected. When in edit mode, rotation and scaling occur around the center point of the active element, which is indicated by a white outline. This center point remains stationary while everything else is transformed around it. As a result, the active vertex, edge, or face rotates in place while the others orbit around it. It's worth noting that in the case of vertices, the active vertex remains unchanged since it's just a point with no concept of rotation. In this mode, the pivot point is positioned at the center of the bounding box, which is a tightly wrapped box that surrounds the selection and is aligned with the world axis. When a single object is selected, the pivot point coincides with the object's origin point. However, if multiple objects are selected, the pivot point shifts to the center of an imaginary box that encompasses their origins. Observe the pivot point in motion as I continue to select the four cubes before us. This pivot point option is also useful when you want to make a group of objects behave as a single object, allowing you to rotate, scale, or transform them as a whole. The median pivot point is a valuable option in Blender that allows for precise transformations. By selecting this option, the program calculates the center point of the selected objects and uses it as the pivot point. This method is particularly useful as it takes into account the averaged out position of the origins of the objects, rather than their shape and size. In edit mode, it is important to note that the pivot point will shift towards the area with the densest geometry. For example, if one cube has more subdivisions than another, the pivot point will shift towards the denser cube, even if they are similar in size. Some of you may be under the impression that the bounding box and median pivot point modes are one and the same. However, there is a distinct difference between the two. To clarify, let's examine a set of four cubes, each spaced evenly apart. In bounding box mode, the pivot point of the three cubes is automatically set to the center, without the need to select the fourth cube. This is because the box that encompasses all three cubes has a center point. Conversely, in median point mode, the pivot point shifts to the average of all three cubes. Only when the fourth cube is selected will the pivot point move to the center. One other thing is, it's important to note that the origins of all four cubes have been moved to this location. As a result, even if the objects are elsewhere, the pivot point remains here. This is because both the bounding box and median point modes take the origins of the objects into account, rather than the geometry of the object itself. Thank you for joining us for our tutorial on pivot points in Blender. We hope that this introduction has been helpful in expanding your knowledge of this essential tool, and that you can now use it to enhance your workflow and create even more stunning 3D artwork. Understanding pivot points is a crucial aspect of Blender's toolkit, and with practice, you can become a master of using them to achieve your creative goals. So, keep experimenting and learning, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more Blender tutorials and tips in the future. If you're interested in mastering the 3D cursor, be sure to check out our tutorial on that topic as well. We're always here to help you improve your skills and take your artwork to the next level. Thank you for choosing our tutorial, and happy blending.